Happy New Year! I am Master Tofu Flower and welcome to my tutorial. I will post videos regularly, so please subscribe and turn on your notification button so you don't miss any of our videos. Today, I will discuss about the primer layer on Ulushi lacquerware. This is one of the most important steps of making when it comes to buying or making Ulushi lacquerware. With proper care, Ulushi lacquerware can last for centuries. The base or primer layer is the foundation of the Ulushi paint. It is the secret of exceptional durability of lacquerware. The application of this layer requires lots of time, care, and skills. And it is the reason why a plain black Ulushi lacquerware is so expensive. The primer layer serves several functions. It repairs surface defect on the substrate. A substrate is the object that you want to paint on. The primer layer also seals, protects, and strengthens the substrate, which then improves the binding of Ulushi paint to the substrate. Hence, it improves the durability of the Ulushi lacquerware. In addition, it also enhances insulation, making your soup stay nice and warm for longer. Meow! I will show you the importance of primer. Here, we have two bottle caps, one with Hongji primer, and the other one was sanded with 400 grit sandpaper and a thin layer of raw Ulushi. Without the primer, the Ulushi paint cannot withstand human scratch. See? It can be easily scraped off with a 2B pencil. With Hongji primer, the paint cannot be damaged by human fingernails or 2B pencil lead. This important primer layer is found in all Ulushi lacquerware with a few exceptions. For example, the lacquerware does not require a primer layer if the Ulushi is applied on an absorbent surface, such as paper, cloth, or flexible surfaces, such as leather or woven bamboo. Also, no primer layer is needed for specific Ulushi techniques that aim at highlighting the beauty of the wooden substrate, such as Fuki Ulushi and Kichilo Nuri. If your lacquerware is made for a 7-day show, the primer is not necessary either. As we will discuss later, applying primer layer is a time-consuming process that demands care and skill. Unfortunately, evil sellers or lazy crafters can sell you extremely low-quality lacquerware without a primer layer, which is totally unacceptable. Meow! Without the primer layer, the Ulushi paint can chip, crack, or peel off within a year, since the primer layer is hidden at the very bottom. It is not easy to identify without damaging the lacquerware. You should ask about the primer layer before buying the lacquerware. If the seller says it is not important, it's a lie. They may start giving you silly excuses and get angry at you. Don't buy from them. If they are not sure, be very careful and judge wisely. Meow. Some materials used in the primer layer are very interesting. They shall include, but not limited to, raw Ulushi, rice flour, unripe persimmon jam, charcoal powder, diatomaceous earth, animal skin glue, plain flour, chalk, cloth, paper, clay powder, and even blood. There are three main methods of priming: Honkataji, Honji, and Makiji. Alternatively, Nuri Kasane and other methods shall be used in specific situations. Honkataji is the kanji character, meaning basic rigid primer. It is a standard primer in good quality lacquerware. Weak spots, such as corners, or the entire substrate is reinforced by fabric to hold the paint on the substrate. Then multiple layers of paint consisting of rice flour, diatomaceous earth, clay powder, and raw Ulushi are applied. This is the strongest and the most durable primer, making the paint unlikely to peel off or chip. It is very resistant to humidity and temperature change. However, the method of priming is very labor-intensive and time-consuming. Proper honkataji takes a master crafter 21 to 28 days. It usually takes a skilled crafter 30 to 40 days for the process. Also, this primer layer is very thick, around 1 mm, and may not be suitable in some situations. This diagram shows the cross-section of honkataji. Layer 4, which is the fabric, is holding layer 3, 5, 6, and 7, which are clay urushi primer layers. Hanji is another common method. The kanji character means basic primer. The process is similar to honkataji but without the fabric reinforcement. The primer paint layers are usually simpler and thinner than honkataji. This priming method is easier and less time-consuming. It is especially suitable on small objects, such as a fountain pen. However, it is not as durable as honkataji. Makiji is the kanji character, meaning sprinkled primer. Don't mix it up with makie method, which is sprinkled painting. In this method, raw urushi is painted on a substrate and dry powder such as charcoal or clay powder is sprinkled on it. This primer is thinner than the previous two methods. Also, it is less time-consuming and easier to work with. The surface of the finished product has a sandstone texture and is resistant to cat scratch and even metal scratch. It is less durable than the previous two priming methods. This priming method is commonly used on small objects and tableware. Nurikasane is technically not a priming method, but it is useful in some situations, so I mention it here. The kanji character means painting in multiple layers, typically more than 10 layers. It is very easy to prepare, but time-consuming, which typically takes more than 11 days. The finished coat is thinner, but less durable than the other methods. This technique uses more urushi paint, so that it is more expensive. It is useful in areas that require thin paint or difficult to sand. Other primers can be found on some lower quality antique lacquerware, such as gesso, pig blood, and persimmon jam primer. They are historical and rarely used in modern days. These primers are less durable than the standard three methods, and lacquerware requires special care. Master Tofu Flower's take-home message today: applying primer is a time-consuming and complex process. It is essential for durability of the lacquerware. Bad seller may sell you lacquerware with low quality or even no primer layer. You should inquire about the primer before buying it, and that will make you sound smart too. If you have any questions, leave a comment down below. And if you like this video, please give it a big thumbs up and share our video to your friends. Thanks for watching. I will show you how to apply honkataji, honji, and makiji in future video. See you next time. Meow!